Dear students, our today's topic is to discuss about the chromosomes. Every nucleated cell has a thread-like structure, and these thread-like structures are called chromosomes. And the chromosomes were first discovered by a German cytologist W. Waldeyer in the half of the 19th century. They are present in all nucleated cells. And these chromosomes are made up of DNA and protein, and two types of proteins are present, having acidic and basic nature, and in majority of cases the basic protein, that is histone, is present. Chromosomes, the term indicates that these thread like structures can be colored or can become colored or can become stained through certain dyes. And here the example of a dye that is used to stain the chromosome is acetocarmine, and these thread like structures become colored. That's why these are called chromos, that is colored, and soma means body, that is colored body present inside the nucleus. Chromosome shows a differential pattern of staining, that is all chromosomes do not uniformly stained. Certain part of the chromosome becomes darkly stained, and these dark regions are called heterochromatin, whereas the light regions are called euchromatins. It shows that the chromosomes shows the variable pattern of condensation. Chromosomes are visible when they are tightly packed, that is when the cells are dividing. Remember that in non-dividing cells, the chromatin fibers remain loosely bound, but when the cells divide, these chromatin fibers get condensed into the form of chromosomes. When the cells are not dividing, that is in interface conditions, the chromosomes form a diffuse network of thread called chromatin. Here, this figure shows a nucleus. This is nucleolus present inside the nucleus, and this thread-like structure is called chromatin. When this chromatin is observed, when it is loosely bound, it remains simply in the form of a thread, and when this chromatin fiber becomes condensed or tightly packed, it develops into a chromosome. And when it is loosely bound, it can be isolated or visualized separately in the form of DNA fiber. And during DNA replication or DNA, when the cell divides, we know that every cell doubles its genetic material or DNA, and each copy of each DNA remains attached at its centromere. That's why when the cell divides, then only the chromosomes can be visualized, and every chromosome has its identical copy attached through the centromere, and these identical copy are called the sister chromatids. Here these two chromosomes, both the chromosomes are same copy of same chromosome. So, and the basic chromosome number N, it varies from species to species, but for a species this basic chromosome number remains same, and there is no relation, or the basic chromosome number N is unrelated to the size and complexity of an organism. Every diploid human cell contains a total of 46 chromosomes. These 46 chromosomes can be separated into two groups. 44 chromosomes, those forms autosomes, are same in both male and female, whereas the 23rd pair of the chromosome, that is the last pair of chromosome, forms the sex chromosome, and these two chromosomes are same in female XX and XY in male. The basic chromosome number N is the 23 in case of human beings, and this is called the haploid genome represented by N. And all human cells have a multiple of this number. Generally, every cell is diploid, so there is the 2n number of each cell, and hence the number is 46. But certain cells are triploid or hexaploid, such as some liver cells may have a multiple of this basic number, the basic set of chromosome. Here this figure shows the haploid chromosome number in different species. Here some species are highlighted. Midge has only 10 haploid numbers, that is n is 10 in case of midge. In fruit fly or Drosophila, it is 4. In human beings, there is 23 haploid number of chromosome. So we, from this figure, we can see that the haploid chromosome number is unrelated with the complexity or size of an organism. That is, a simple organism may have, such as this Baker's yeast fungus, a simple organism as compared to the human beings, or as compared to the G-maze, or as compared to the fruit fly. But here it has the basic chromosome number or haploid chromosome number 16, as against the only 4, the more complex organism as compared to the yeast, that is Drosophila, which has only 4 chromosomes.